Hi, ladies and gentlemen, here we are today for another amazing Zoominar lecture. And what to say about the couple today? Well, easy. The most famous amateur couple in the WDC and WDC Amateur League. Here we have today, and we're so honored to have them, Clement and Sasha. Please, welcome.
Thank you.
Looking forward to hear your lecture.
So, hello to everyone. Good morning, good evening, wherever you are. We are absolutely honored and so happy to be able actually to give this lecture. We would like to thank in advance already because it can happen at the end.
We are on time.
So we would like to thank Mirko, Fred, Nicole, and the whole team for organizing all of this super knowledgeable classes. We've been enjoying some of the past lectures, and for sure we will be enjoying some of the lectures in the future. I think it's a great thing, and it shows you how beautiful the WDC family is. Thank you for that.
Yes, right. Moving on to our subject today.
So the title of the lecture, we have the qualities of the in the WDC form of Latin dance. So when we received the title, it was a little bit maybe we got a little bit scared by it, right? Because it's such a big subject. It's so many qualities that we feel that that the couples possess, and so many qualities that is looked for in the WDC field. So it was a little bit like, okay, what should we focus on? We have only 1 hour. But on the other side, then more than we were starting to think about, actually it's such a good lecture because it's, like I said, so many great qualities, so many possibilities to discuss so many different things. We will today just focus on few because otherwise we can stay here till tomorrow. Some qualities that we feel we strongly believe in as a couple. And what we see also in the other couples, and what we when we talk with the teachers, with other couples, with judges, it's basically the priorities, maybe. Or what also separates us from other fields, other federations, and so on. So, few things, and we would start with maybe not the most important one, but that we feel maybe it's a fundamental thing, and actually it's more of a requirement for the other qualities. Actually, it gives the possibility, it opens the doors for all the other qualities that we want to show. It is basically the basic principles, the fundamentals, the personal coordination, and everything that goes with it. So basically, all of the mechanics. Now, I know that this maybe is not necessarily straight away received as a quality, but we strongly believe that whatever is perfected to the degree that it's done, that you become really outstanding in it, it's a quality by itself. So, like for example, if you practice your Roomba walk to the perfection, we believe that's a quality. Or, you know, cha-cha lockstep, or samba whisk, or whatever. So, I think what is really important for us nowadays is basically that we, first of all, prepare our bodies that it's possible then to do a great Roomba walk or a great samba action.
And this is actually the requirement, sorry if I interrupt you, but this is a requirement for the quality, not only maybe in WDC or not maybe only in Latin, but generally what you would expect from a dancer, right? That your body is ready, that your body is able to do something. To do that, of course, you have to be in great shape, you have to be well coordinated, and you have to spend time to actually find all of these coordinations in your body. Find the ways to make your body to go to the limit. Then you can actually use it to express whatever style of dance you do or whatever movement you want to do.
And here I think it goes all of the physical exercises that us dancers are doing nowadays, from strength exercises, from stamina exercises, from the flexibility exercises, all of it that basically gives you the body, your tool, to be able to express and bring all of the qualities that you want to show up. So I think that's kind of like a requirement. And then I think where we maybe separate ourselves from other fields is I think we study these mechanics so much, and we first of all in theory in terms of knowledge, in terms of knowing all of this stuff. And then I think even more so in practicing it or drilling it over and over again. And this goes with basically like all of the exercises that maybe are a little bit, you know, not necessarily the most exciting, but actually are necessary for us as dancers. It's basically like an alphabet. So I think like all of the top couples that we see nowadays in our beautiful industry, I think they studied mainly repeating.
We were talking actually with Clement before the lecture, and we were reading what he prepared, what I prepared, so actually to discuss and see where we meet. And then we realized actually what separates like the levels of quality, because of course you have poor quality, which we don't want, good quality, like let's say average, good, excellent, and above excellent, yeah, outstanding qualities. And where actually we find this separation between this, I think it's the level of details, a level of how much time and effort we are able or we are willing to give to the certain step or to the certain action. This is where you see actually the progress and quality. Yeah? That's why I think you can see all of the greatest dancers come in the hall. You don't see them, okay, straight away to go to your routine or whatever, but they try to learn even more about this hip twist, even more about this opening out, whatever it is they are striving to perfect. Because the more you go in it, the more actually you find, oh, how, what else can I pull out of that? So actually, we realize that the quality is not made overnight. You can't achieve quality just like that. Yeah, you need to do it, you need to make mistakes, you need to learn from these mistakes, and then hopefully with all this knowledge and experience, you can lift the quality of your dance.
Yeah. And I think like, really, you know, you could say that all of this is basically a requirement for us to bring the stuff, a little bit more complex stuff out. But I really believe that when it's done, like when you really become masterful in it, it's a quality by itself. And even by that, you know, it's a huge advantage if you possess that. And if you're willing to spend that time. Also, if you're unwilling to spend that time, you will always, even if you want to show a great musicality, great partnering skills, great storytelling, you will always lack a little bit of fundamentals to bring these things up. So yeah, I think this is, for me, that's why we started from it, because I think this is like a fundamentals that you would build your house on it. And then if we move on, because we don't want to spend too much time on
this. Because we also want to a little bit dance later, so yeah, we have time for everything. So, and also there is a lecture, right? After us, yeah, there is one of the lectures, which is about fundamentals, and I'm sure it will be a great lecture. So guys will talk more about that.
Yeah, so then for us, like Sasha said before, we prepared basically her list and my list, and then we compared it a few days ago.
To see if we have the same qualities.
You know, we normally find out that we would talk completely about different stuff. But surprisingly enough, there were some things that we both agreed with. Yeah? So then another point was, I think, where we really separate from other form of dances and maybe other federations. I think the partnering skills, right? The
you will be surprised, I agree.
Yeah, she agrees on that one. The partnering skills, where we think not only physical, where normally we perceive this as a physical lead and follow and push and pull, but we believe it's strongly also here on a non-physical connection, and it's more than just physical connection. Let's
So actually what we wanted to do today, we wanted to take few of the subject and go kind of in the layers inside of the subject, because like we said before, the deeper you dig in one subject, the more quality you can get out of that one subject. It's like this kind of pyramid reverse. Yeah, you want to go to this point of the really understanding it, and I guess you never come really to the end. It's never ending story. Yeah.
And I think like we said before, right? If I spend so much time by myself on my mechanics, on knowing stuff, now I have the possibility, you know, to really give my body weight and my knowledge and share it with my partner, and vice versa. Because I think if I would lack already my fundamentals, or if you would skip a little bit this part, you could talk about this as much as you want, but it's a little bit, you wouldn't get the same. So we strongly believe that in the partnering, or if you call it like the partnering skills, it is not only always that the guy leads and the girl follows, and we don't normally even use these words, right? I think, and Sasha, whoever knows her, she has a strong opinion, right? So I, you know, normally I will not be able to have her being forced into something that she doesn't want. Which in the beginning, maybe, you know, it was a little bit confusing because, you know, if we decided something and she decides now to do it another way, you know, how come we decided like this?
No, let me tell you the story how it was really in the beginning. When we started to dance together, everybody who knows Clement knows his artistic side, and he really likes to maybe hear and connect to the music and change a few beats and change a few steps and lengthen the step here and put an extra bar here. It was a shock for me. First competition, we prepare everything good. First competition, I'm like, oh my God, what is happening? Well, it's all different steps, it's all different choreography. At that time, I thought, okay, how can I find a way to actually deal with that, not losing myself? First, of course, it was, okay, I just follow. This was a period when I lost myself completely as a dancer, so let's say, as my character. But then actually trying to find inside of that cut how I can react, how I can actually make him know what I want in that moment. His quality of listening to the music and being more alive brought qualities inside of me that I'm actually quite, let's say, proud of myself today, that actually I became very reactive. So I started to listen more to him, listen to the music, and being really in it, because I realized otherwise I can't follow, I can't give anything to the partnership. So in that way, I think it's great because the qualities inside of the couple doesn't have to be particularly the same. We don't have to have the same qualities, but we actually can enhance the qualities of each other if we bounce off.
Yeah, I think this is really important. I think, like, also for the couples who are watching, you know, in the beginning when we are young, you know, only one way, and it has to be that way. And for me, like, it was a big deal that I learned that actually, you know, we can be much more successful if I allow Sasha to bring the qualities out that she possesses, and I maybe don't have them as my priorities or as my strong point, and vice versa. So, like, for example, in the beginning, for me, everything was about energy, dynamics, power, let's go, right? And for Sasha, everything was about aesthetics, beauty, softness, and it was a shock. Like, how can you
do this? So you can imagine our practice.
Yeah, how can you do this thing? And everything was, for me, was too mellow. For her, was like, you know, it was like Frankenstein. So we needed to find a way to combine this. And I'm so happy that actually you stood by your things, and that we actually found a way that...
You didn't give me any other option. It's either take it or leave it.
So why I'm saying this, because like maybe for the younger couples, we are too often, we want our partners to be exactly like us. But actually, we don't want that. I experienced that as well with her, when she wanted to be, when she was pleasing me and she did what I asked. It was much worse. So... The suggestion, what is, I think, really good in our field, is that even inside the couple, we have two very unique dancers, very different to each other. And then they make it work as a unique brand, as a unique couple. And I think this is so special and so good to see. And everybody is a little bit different. And I think, this is
that's why actually it's exciting to see the competitions, because you see these greatest couples that they're so different from each other. And inside of the couple, you can see two characters. What can be more beautiful?
Maybe if we don't just talk about it, let's just take an example, and maybe let's do the closing in Feb in Google.
From our...
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, we can.
Whatever.
So what we want to show is basically that I can give a very strong direction to Sasha, what I want from her. And she can obey and 100% go with it, and it will be one thing. Or she can also decide to take the input and maybe put it in her own way. So, for example, like if we take it and going into the fan, and now I want her to close her feet fast, bring back fast. So, you know, I have to be very clear with my direction. I have to be very clear with my intention. Whoa. She decided, boom, straight away to do it differently. So even now, you know, I actually wanted her to close her feet fast. She decided to take her time and close
her feet. I was trying to close fast, but then to actually let
go. And then you have basically the possibility, I can keep doing that. And And if I listen, that's actually, it creates another layer of interesting things. Where normally in the beginning, you know, I would be Superman, because we decided you close your feet fast.
This is too, he would scream, this is too.
And then I realized, well, wait, but actually this looks better. I was super snappy and she took her time and okay, I listen and then boom. So she was happy with that she could do her stuff. And I was happy because actually, oh, this looked better. I had to put my ego a little bit aside, but actually this looks better.
So again, like even if you do just how we planned, how we planned to this figure to look, it's still, there is a quality inside of that. Hopefully, because we practice so much time, so many years we dance together, there is a quality of just doing like a fan close and going in. Yeah. But now, the next level, when we talk about the layers, right, will be, what can I do with that in that particular moment? Because of course we know that when we dance on the competition, we get different music, different audience, different hall. So if you are really, I believe, if you are really a quality dancer, you take all of that into consideration. You don't go just, okay, this is what I practice and I will really just do that and nothing else. Then I feel we lose the best, for me, the best quality of our dancing is this life factor. It sounds maybe a bit funny now because we have this lecture for no one in the studio now, but hopefully that our world will come back to this more live performance. But still, yeah, I feel like it will be connected with what I feel in that moment, how Clement will behave, what I will hear from the music, what I will feel from the audience, and what will be appropriate in that moment. And this, I feel, really separates maybe WDC also in that way, that I feel that whatever is done is really appropriate to the event, how couples are dressing, how they behave, how the whole event, everything feels like appropriate. And I feel it gives a little bit of sense of class to the whole thing, yes? The sense of taste, yeah? So maybe if we demonstrate again, I can put something like of my own. Yeah, it doesn't matter. And of course, I think if we are talking about of the high level, every time when we do it, it will slightly be different to the other.
Yeah, I think that's really the spontaneity, or basically being really in the moment. And I think this is what we want, you know. It's not just that we practice hours and hours and hours to be actually able to deliver a spontaneous performance. And I think this is the ultimate thing.
Paradox.
Yeah, and sometimes it is difficult because you practice over and over and over and you can go on autopilot. But actually, if you have this aim that you are practicing over and over and over to trust yourself and trust your partner so much that you can then really be in the moment and respond to the atmosphere, to the music, to the occasion, to each other, I think that's the ultimate. And that's what we strongly believe in, what we strongly strive for, and what is also, we believe in, looked as a strong quality on the floor.
And you see, we didn't really mention not once a thing, okay, push, pull, lead, and something like that. It was more of the holistic approach to following your partner and giving something to it. So it's much more rich.
You have to go through the stages, but and then if we are talking about partnering now, and you know, I mentioned already earlier, it's not only that I constantly tell my partner what to do and then okay, hopefully she decides, but it's also that I, a lot of times, I really listen to her. And she kind of takes the leading role or the.
Actually, you listen all the time. You just don't know about this.
I have to, otherwise, you know, I came prepared with my lecture. I show her the script. She said, so, for example, we'll take a piece in the room, but the one that you're leading and I'm following with the link. So if you take this, and what we will demonstrate is basically, I, in that particular moment, I have to really listen and respond with my body weight. Then Sasha finishes her action and then I take her out. So she's the leading one and I'm the following one.
And it's not maybe particularly a rumba step that we would say, okay, this is a cube motion or something. So we took it actually more from a contemporary style. So the lead and the follow here is different to what we normally talk about, the Cuban action or something. Yeah.
So you took it maybe from the walks. respond. I can listen to take it out at the right moment. So if I would try to do this step, if you just go from here, I stop Sasha, and then if I try to lead her, I'm never in balance. I can't really respond. So we figured out that actually when we come here, I have to respond right at the end. I take over and I take her out. So it's constantly, and this is just an example, but it's constantly, we have so many places like this where I have to really listen, really be committed and sense her body weight, sense when she's ready to take her out, take over again. So, and then, like we mentioned earlier, partnering skills or partnering, it's such a big subject. And I think in our field, we really excel in it. So that's why we are talking a little bit more in it, more about it. It's a huge subject also when we are not doing it maybe necessarily in the physical connection, right? So many times you would have some side-by-side pieces or some pieces when we are not actually holding, when we are not physically connected. And I think in that part, sometimes, you know, it can go wrong because we completely lose the sense for each other. And I think the dancers or the couples on the top in our federation, they strongly possess this skills and they are constantly interacting, talking with each other, playing with each other. And we strongly believe in that as well. We strongly believe that Like now, we are not talking both at the same time. I'm talking, then Sasha is talking, and then I'm talking, then she
tells me to shut up. You should see some of the practices. Then,
yeah. So we are not both screaming at the same time because you can't hear us. And dancing is a little bit like this as well. So we are constantly giving the ball to each other. So let's just take an example, and we show a little bit what we mean by this maybe we take judge the side-by-side part that we have. So if you dance, this part, let's just show what this part is. So we do one, two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and two, and three, and two, and three, and two. Okay. So that's kind of the section. We are not really physically connected until the last moment. And the part by itself, it's nothing really special. And it can look very dry and very, you know, not really interesting because you're just doing the steps. And even though if you're trying to do a good action, right?
Yes.
It doesn't really come out across strong on the competition.
So it will be not enough, let's say, to achieve the superb quality or the higher quality if I just do, let's say, the correct mechanics, the correct body coordination, and just stay in that zone, because it will always feel like, for me, when I see this kind of dancing, I can appreciate the effort and I can appreciate the structure of it, but it leaves me cold because I feel it's not done now with this person in that moment. It feels like it's done in the studio and we are showing you the studio version.
And I think like really at the top, what actually really attracts me is to see the interaction between the two dancers. That's for me really, really what separates our Latin American form of dancing to maybe some hip hop or like a ballet, or when it's a solo dancer, you know, we have this possibility to interact with another human being. And it's so many possibilities. So I think, yeah, this is something that it's a huge thing. And what I think also it's been perfected with the top couples in our field. So if you try to do now this part again, let's just do it. Let's focus on just mechanics only, but without being really aware of each other. Right?
Can I do that? this will we have to fight first, then I can do this easily.
Exactly. 1, 2, 3, check, 1, 3, check, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Okay. Yeah.
I did not enjoy that, even one bit.
Yeah, you become bored, like halfway through it, you're thinking like, when it's going to be the end. So let's try again. Let's try to give it a little bit of that.
A little bit,
yeah.
Okay.
Okay. 3, 2, 1. 2, 2, 2. invite you to continue to dance. And I think this is beautiful, right? You want to practice, you want to dance, you want to continue to enjoy that. And I think if you're watching that, probably was more interesting. What's going to happen? What's your story than just the mechanics?
Yeah, and of course, it is important to go through the mechanics. And hopefully, you are not losing the mechanics while you're doing it.
Sure.
But sometimes we have to also understand, if you want to excel in something, to achieve really super quality in, let's say, one team or one subject, sometimes you will have to sacrifice something else. Hopefully it will be that much, but you will probably have to, because this is the only way that we stand out in one quality. Not keeping it general, which is okay and good maybe for a few rounds, but what separates the couples on top, I believe, is that you actually take a quality not just as a necessary requirement, but actually as a wow factor, something that one possesses so strongly that we are all attracted to that.
Yeah, and I think this partnering skills, it's such an important, such a big subject that we just covered it briefly now, but it's such a thing that can keep you in the studio, days and days and days. And the beauty of it is you will never get to the end of it. And I think so many times when I think I figured out the step, I know exactly what to give in terms of lead and what I know exactly. She just changes it slightly and it's all new world. And or I change it slightly and she responds, if she's on, and she responds differently and it's another thing. And this is when actually some steps happen that you wouldn't normally do, and then maybe it becomes your new choreography and so on. But why I'm saying this is because I think it's really, really important for the couples to stay open to really listen to each other. So many times, I remember, I wish I would learn this a little bit earlier, but and I'm still learning. It's still you get me on a bad day, and I can see myself shut to
I think we all do.
Yeah, but it's a beautiful world once you put a little bit your ego aside and you just allow it to go with it. And
I think it's really important to respect each other and respect and know each other's quality. This, I think, is also very important. Why do we talk actually about qualities in general? Yeah, we all strive, we want to quality, but what? Because first of all, of course, it's something that puts you aside, maybe from others, but also what I realized, it gives you knowing your qualities, gives you some kind of freedom and feeling, I know that, I can handle that. For example, for today's lecture, if you ask me, am I nervous? Okay, of course, I am nervous. Are you, was a little bit not sure? Yes. But on the other side, I'm excited and I want to do it because I know that I have some qualities that I want to share with you. So this gives me a feeling of stability. And I feel we all need that feeling. We need, of course, to work on our faults and defects. But then in the end, we want to actually put out and bring out the qualities that we have. And so it makes me feel more, I know what I'm doing.
And what is really so beautiful about our world and even about this title of this lecture is there are so many qualities, and there are because if it would be only perceived, this is quality and everything else is not, it would be quite limiting, and we would all strive and we would try to put ourselves in little boxes. And I think it's so good that it's encouraged in our world to be actually unique, to find your own qualities and find, you can basically be successful on a lot of different ways.
Which has to actually encourage couples right now, right? Even if I'm born maybe not so stretched or whatever is my, I can still succeed, I can still come to the top because I can maybe excel in other types of qualities.
It's so many different ways, that you can succeed. So there is no really you shouldn't find excuses, this is basically, yes, maybe you are not the tallest, so what? Find something that you can actually excel, or maybe you are not the most flexible. So many possibilities to basically bring this.
So actually, that's why we were really happy when we read the first one I read, I was like, the quality of WPC, and I'm okay. But then I read more carefully, qualities, and I think this is much nicer subject and much more wide and actually more encouraging, because there is, you can see how much is inside, right?
So maybe if we move on and we cover a little bit the other subject, because like I said, we could be here and pointing out the qualities like till tomorrow.
But we basically talk more of the qualities that we feel made us successful and that we appreciate to see.
Yeah, we can talk maybe a little bit more from our point of view, right? But also when we look around, you see like in what covers are outstanding and what is basically being searched for. And we saw it a little bit, the music or musicality, responding to the music is a really strong thing. And it's been constantly a big subject or a big, like very high on a priority list for us. Subject that I personally, as a young kid, was drawn very much to. And that was basically my first love. And it kind of kept
me. It was not me. Oh my God.
One of the biggest love. Okay. It was the first one. And I think like this is also when I look around and what really touches people is a lot of times when somebody or a couple does something really in sync with the music, when you can just melt because this was so nicely with the music. And I think this is on a lot of couples' priority is very high, and a lot of one thing is that really we are lucky that because the judges, the spectators who are coming to watch our competitions are very knowledgeable people in dancing. So, you know, we can then trust that even the audience will recognize the skills or the outstanding qualities in that. Because if people wouldn't be so knowledgeable, it would be maybe not so necessary to search for such qualities, for such depth. But like this, I think this gives you the drive and this gives you also the possibility to go deeper into that.
So when we talk about the music, again, like we said before, it's so many layers inside. Of course, we can say, okay, that there is a quality in knowing exactly your perfect time and being very clear with putting your feet on the floor and exact time. There is a quality in knowing how much is half and how much is quarter and what is exactly the timing of that step and that. But again, maybe it is again more of a requirement and more of a, what can I do then? Yeah, what is the next layer? Yeah, and then we want to listen to the music that is playing now. We want to feel that I can portray the character in the music which is playing now. Maybe the next trombone or the next samba will not be the same. Yeah, so again, if I am able to show this difference between that song and this one, I think it again puts a little bit maybe higher quality. You can see it in the couples on the floor.
And for myself, I was always like drawn to the music. So when I was younger, you know, when I heard a certain tune, I could completely change my routine. I could completely do another dance. It wasn't like, you know, I hear this, so I just did this. And when we got together with Sasha, that was a little bit, like she said earlier, like a shocker now, because obviously we practice over and over, and then I heard something on a competition, I went a completely different way. But one thing was really good at that. She was very encouraging at that point. She didn't say, okay, don't you ever do this again. But she said,
yeah, okay, because I was in shock.
She said, okay, let's find a way that I will get the message or that what you feel inside your body will get to, that I will receive this and that I can respond in my own way. So I thought at that time that was great. So it was actually, okay, I did a complete mess up of the first competition, but rather than actually she said, okay, don't do this and be more, she actually encouraged me to do it more, but just giving her the possibility to know what I'm going to do or what, you know. And if we wouldn't spend enough time again on the personal coordination and mechanics, and especially to develop the patterning skills, this could go very wrong. So that's why we also started the lecture a little bit in that order, because we feel like this two subject has to be really strongly there in order to be able to express the music.
At least for us, this is how it worked in our career.
And again, you know, you have to understand that how I listen to the music and how I would respond to the certain music, it's maybe sometimes is the same what Sasha hears and Sasha would also, but a lot of times it's not. And again, in the beginning, it was a little bit like, how can you not hear? Like, this is a strong beat here. She said, oh, this is the violin, so it's very metal. Yeah, but who cares about the violin? So, you know, it could go
on. I care about the violin.
But when I figured out that actually, okay, but if I just listen to that, You know, I can also I can also hear things in the music that I wouldn't normally hear, and I can then decide to accent it, or maybe I would accent this and she respond.
And don't get us wrong, it does. It's not like it's worked like a charm. Sure. Yeah, and that's why we say. That's why we are saying that actually it requires that to achieve any kind of quality, even if it's just good level or whatever. It requires time. It requires time. It requires to do it over and over again. That's why also I feel it's really important for couples to practice this subject as well, because I feel a lot of times we practice just the mechanical part and maybe performance part in the sense of, oh, where is my focus, how I do that, but we totally ignore this life factor. Yeah, so when you actually come on the floor, on that floor or on that floor or in Paris or in Blackpool, you of course it's different event. It should be different when you are there. It's not the same exactly. Yeah, so I feel we have to spend time to actually practice that as well.
Absolutely, and I think that even when you practice just the mechanics or just your rumba walk, it's actually very difficult, and I don't believe it's maybe necessarily right to separate and completely forget about other things. Our teacher Donnie always says, you know, even if it's just a mechanical exercise, commit 100% with all your soul, with all your body, and we strongly believe in that as well, because so many times I tried to do it just mechanical and just didn't look that I'm doing anything mechanical, you know, correct. And even though I was focusing, my 100% focus was just on this. But when I drag the inspiration also from the beautiful piece of music, and when I devoted the whole soul and my spirit to that movement, I did a much better action. Just if you just compare the actions, the action was so much better. So I think it's really important that the couples are trying to also practice it in that way, not just, you know, because so many times you see, okay, today I'm practicing mechanics, and okay, tomorrow I'm practicing mechanics, and you're practicing mechanics, yes. And how about all of the other 99 things? and music is such a big thing, right?
So we were thinking how to not only talk about this, but also let you see something, and hopefully that you can see the difference, and hopefully that you can see how we can improve or see or actually detect the quality inside of that.
Yeah, so let's maybe, we didn't prepare this, okay? In theory we did, but we didn't try, so. Yeah,
on purpose, because like we say, it should be life, so.
So we'll try it like a piece in our routine, but it's actually side by side, so it's a little bit more difficult even to connect with you to each other. We'll try just a few different tunes of cha-cha music, and we will try our best to kind of get the essence of this music and deliver according to that music, because you have a script, but then, you know, script a lot of times has to go a little bit, has to bend according to the music. So I'll just play
so something. What we actually will try when we talk about this music, of course we have already something planned, the rhythmical part, but of course we are so sensitive to each other, we will try to feel what the other person does, or really strongly put myself into it, so I make a statement. And I think it's very important to really listen to the character of the music that is playing, because cha-cha can be played in so many different types of cha-cha you have. You have some funky cha-chas, you have some maybe more Cuban, so immediately it gives a different feel in the body. So this hopefully you also show in the same piece of the choreography.
All right, so let's give it a go. Try another one so we see how that goes.
Oh yes, bring so many memories. Thank you.
So shall we try another one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Why not?
Try something very different. Respond to the music, then trying to stay in your safe zone and just do it exactly the same. Doesn't matter the music, doesn't matter the occasion, doesn't matter the space. And I think this is a strong quality when couples take, they have the courage to actually pursue this and they go a little bit after that. And you can see so many times in the past when the audience just went absolutely mad about somebody, was a lot of times connected to them being really in that moment with the music and responding and hitting these beats and accenting. And for me personally, what I really strongly strive for is I want to show every music that is playing, and we're very lucky in the WBC field that we have normally such a good music, you know, either recorded or live. That gives you the possibility to show so many different rhythms, to show so many different musicalities, rhythm patterns, and so on.
I think really what you said is so nice, like about being brave. Like you actually have to be brave to do something like this. Yes, to just go out and really, okay, I really commit and I really, if I will hear that note, I will really stamp the foot and I will do that. And this for me also shows when I see on the floor the quality of the couple. Because it means for me that they actually themselves trust so much in their qualities, what they did before. They trust so much that they learn and they did all their drills and they have all of this figured out, that then they can actually let go and really like commit to that. For me, this always is so nice to see.
Yeah, and like we said before, you know, it's very important that we spend time on the other subjects, because if I now just hear music great and everything and I neglect her, nobody will say that this is a great quality. But if it's supported by the other subject that we mentioned earlier, I think it is. And for me, that's very important. And it touches me when I see couples responding to that. And everybody hears it differently. So that's the beauty of it. Because so many times I saw a couple dancing, accenting very different stuff that maybe I would normally accent. But it was so nice because it made me actually hear these things. And this, like I said earlier, in our field, it's so nice because it's accepted. All of these differences are accepted, and I think that really
which brings us to the next point, right? Yeah. Like all of that, what we said before, brings us to the next point that we want to emphasize as a quality is actually the uniqueness of someone or a couple. I feel this, of course, is like the ultimate goal for all of us as a dancers. You want to be unique in something or just recognized. Or to bring something from your own soul, from your own experience, and to give it to people so they actually, you know, can absorb it. And maybe, I don't know, maybe they will learn something from it. Maybe they are sharing the same emotions as you. And this, I feel, is like always attracts people and attracts attention.
I think this is great. And I think like we are so, so lucky and blessed to actually being encouraged throughout our career to constantly being creative and find maybe different ways of doing some stuff. And we've been extremely lucky with our teachers and we've been extremely lucky with our industry that basically that supported it and not only supported, but they actually pushed us to find these things. And, you know, so many times I even if you watch some, maybe some other forms, so many times, it's impressive, but it doesn't, like, after 5 minutes, I get enough, because I think I've seen the whole field, because everything is pretty much the same. And I think in the top field, in top couples in our field, I think this is so beautiful because it's so different. They're so different and so, like, so unique.
And I feel like really, especially lately, listening to all the lectures online from our great teachers, the ones that we really admire and the ones that, of course, we listen, you can hear that they all actually, when they talk about what our dancing needs and what they want to see, is this character and uniqueness from the couple. I feel that we all see that, but we want even more, right?
And for us personally now, of course, like, we are all aware that it's been a difficult situation around the world, and you know, nobody really wanted this to happen. And I think there isn't a single person really now that would say, okay, I really enjoyed that last year. But in a way, for us, it kind of gave us even more the possibility. The possibility was always there, but maybe because before everything was so packed with different things and keeping on the schedule, it kind of puts you in the routine that you just follow. You don't no longer dig as deep as maybe you could. And now with all of this time that we all had in store right now, you know, it gives us the possibility to explore and go deeper in the subjects, and we're realizing how much more is there actually to it. So hopefully when all of the things return, we couples can bring a new level to all of it. And I think this is also kind of encouraging, right? Like that, you know, you're not only like waiting for this time to pass. But yeah, I completely agree with you that, you know, this uniqueness, this this personal style is such a big quality, because for me it is great when I look at the couples, for instance, let's say when you would look at top couples in the final and you would look at the room, it's such deep, it's like a different dance from each couple. And I think that's so nice because it's their version of our version of the room.
You always when they're leading the competition and I hear that voice and couples, this is your version of Samba or something. Actually, every time I feel like it's like a reminder for me, wake up and wow, it's really like my time to put what I feel or what I want people to see on the floor.
Absolutely, yeah, because you know, a rumba for me can be a very different thing, but it's rumba for Sasha and can be especially a different thing, but it's rumba for another couple. So I think what is great that we have this possibility to be able actually to, this is my interpretation of course, we are striving for technical perfection and we are improving these things. This is maybe something that is not negotiable, right? But there are interpretations, the story, the character that, you know, you should stick to it. And I think the couples are more and more and more again sticking to their beliefs and their interpretation of it.
So maybe just a little bit like to feel about this mechanics and this, sometimes some couples, even when I work with someone, right, listen, why actually do we need then all these rules, you know, like why can't I just go and express myself? And I felt like on one of the lectures, Ruben May said really great thing, like rules protect the style. This I felt like, wow, this really answers the whole question about that. Because if you want to keep our Latin American dancing still as a Latin American to separate from others, we have to have some structure. We have to have some rules and boundaries, how we actually keep it looking as our field. Yeah, of course we get inspired by all other ideas, all other dances and styles and that, but still we need this to actually protect our own industry, our own world that we all love so much.
Just before we go, because you mentioned it in the beginning already, but I just wanted to, because it was on both of our lists, and I think like we strongly believe in, and I think looking at other couples, what separates us or what separates really the top of the field or us to another fields is really that attention to details. And I think attention to details in all forms, can it be mechanical, can it be partnering, can it be music, can it be just a simple touch, so many things. But this attention to details, I think it's such a good quality, because so many times it happened to me that I watched a certain couple dance and I rewinded the tape. And I watched it again, and I rewind it maybe 10 times, and I watch it again.
You remember the times when you had to rewind?
And every single time, I notice new things, you know, the details that I overlooked the first time. And because they were so rich, they spent so many hours on that, I could see the same thing new things. You know, and that was so, like, I remember this was many years ago, but it was such a big thing for me. And it's encouraging, I think, like, these things will then live forever, you know, and people will always come back to that. So you wanted to take...
Because now we talked, maybe we talked about a few of the subjects and we came to this uniqueness of Pavel, or uniqueness of you. Of course, this is like a kind of combination of all what we were talking before and of all the other qualities that you can have to then actually put it all together into a piece of your routine and try to find what kind of qualities are inside of that. Of course, always it will be a mixture. I can decide I want to emphasize very strongly in that particular step or piece this kind of quality. Yeah, let's say, okay, here I really want to emphasize how we sell together the moment. Yeah, and then I'm not thinking anymore so much about all my food and this and that, but I really put all my attention to that. Maybe in another piece, I really make it really about more of my collection of my food, and it's maybe not so much connected anymore to this atmosphere between us. So I, as a dancer, can decide what you will hopefully look at.
Yeah, in a way, I think like a really good couple, it's kind of like a really skilled director of a movie. You know, they want...
And actors. Directors and actors.
Absolutely. And I think like they want you to see exactly that thing, and you see this thing and you are, wow, did you see? And I think this is, sometimes that we maybe forget a little bit along the way, okay, when we just practice the mechanics, but it's such a strong thing. Because at the end of the day, we are still selling our product. We are giving the product on the spot, and we hope that people will like it, and we should know what we are selling and what the selling point is in a certain step. And I think, yeah, the storytelling, this characterization, the personal input, it's so important, and it's a big quality by itself.
So we wanted to take a piece of our routine and go through it, maybe dance once for you, like maybe a smaller piece, and then to see an insight and show you what actually can become a quality if you spend time on that. Yeah, just to emphasize something. So should we first dance on the music, or I think it will be better so that you can at least see. And like I say, maybe now we dance and another time it will be different. So we are not really aiming for one exact thing, but just trying to show the differences.
Que la semana tiene más de 7 días para ser mayores y son.
Okay, yeah, just if we don't take it really this, because we hope we can dance at the end a little bit more. What I want to do is basically go through that piece and see what can become a quality or outstanding for, let's say, something that people will see. Because of course I can make it in the different places, different priorities for myself. Of course, in the end, you will see the final product and maybe somebody will just generally say, oh, it's good quality or mediocre quality or something. But just to bring out like really particular things. Yeah. So for example, in the beginning, of course, this is not our time. It's not our beginning of promo. We just took this part. But still, even when I start on the practice or whatever, I still feel, I listen to the music and I listen to them and I already create some kind of tension between us. So like I would say, I feel the ability of creating the atmosphere is a great quality. You can see this in some couples very, very strongly, that when they come on the floor, they create this kind of atmosphere and bubble that you feel immediately like so drawn to that.
Yeah, even before they start to dance, right? Like, Tony always tells this story,
yes.
Judging Black for the Iron, and many of us, we heard it. But yeah, you can actually really separate couples by even before they start to dance. And I think that this is such an important thing that a lot of times, again, it can be neglected, but I think in the top field in our industry. I think
so let's say even here, yes, when we start, we already try to create the episode. Okay, it can be always, I think for me, it will always be connected to what I hear and what I see. Of course, if the music maybe tells something stronger or in a different way, I will react. I will not just, okay, I practice this way. Then it looks very shallow. And this is what I generally don't like about dancing or about anything actually in life, when something is shallow. Because why to practice so many hours and do it general on the surface? Yeah? So let's say we are here, we have this ability to create, and then we have... yeah. So again, here, I decided not to do like maybe hip twist in the, how you say, in the general sense of how it should look, but I decided a little bit to give of my own feeling to that. And again, maybe if I will not feel it, I will not do it. Yeah? But still, yeah, this can become a feature. Okay? Then from here, I'm talking mostly about what I feel feminine.
And I agree.
Wow, I want to do lectures all the time, he agrees. Then when we practice, it's different. Yeah, so then from here we go into this, and then when we are going to this kind of spiral, again, it can be just a perfect spiral. Yeah, I'm doing it perfectly, and I close my feet, and I perfectly set up, but this leaves me a bit dry, you know, like I feel there is not enough of layers of quality in it for myself. So I then felt, okay, I practiced that, but then what about actually I feel I enter Clement's space and almost like I want to touch and feel him with my back and roll into his space and feel how he's leaving me before I create this feeling. Yeah? So that I'm using a little bit, maybe not the qualities that on the surface appear. Oh, in the spiral, maybe it will be more about the straight legs and beautiful how you connect, but also I put in also the attention to him and what is coming next. Yeah, so I know that next is the speed up, so I really sell this kid for us.
Yeah, and I think like what we are doing now is basically coming to the ultimate thing. I think we are basically telling our story, how I would do this step, how I would do this dance. And I think this is such a great thing, you know, like it's like telling your own story, your own life with your dancing. It's such a big possibility, and we are so happy that actually we have this possibility to do this in our field. And I think like, you know, what we are searching now, it's maybe very different to 5 or 10 years ago, because we are in a different age, and you know, like everything, you know, it matures and changes with time, and I think that's great. You know, like different singers, they used to sing a certain song very differently 20 years ago and now, so it changes a lot. I think this is beautiful. So I think we're coming closer to the end, so let's maybe... Yeah, let's maybe... We'll try not to just, you know, keep it here. Yeah, we will just, that's a little bit of our Roomba. Hopefully you find it.
We have our own qualities that we want you to see, but maybe you will find some other qualities. Maybe you will learn from that, or maybe you will have your own opinion about that. So
let's just give it a go. It's a little bit scary, but
it's okay.
Contigo aprendí que existen nuevas y mejores sensaciones. Contigo aprendí a conocer una nueva dimensión. Aprendí que la semana tiene más de 7 días, hacer mayores mis contadas alegrías. que a ser dichoso yo contigo lo aprendí. Contigo aprendí a ver la luz del otro lado de la luz. Contigo aprendí que tu presencia no me cambia por ninguno. Aprendí que soy un beso con más dulce y más profundo, que puedo ir de mañana mismo de este mundo. Las cosas buenas y la contigo las viví, y contigo aprendí que yo nací el día de tu conocimiento.
Beautiful, beautiful guy, fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. And it's so beautiful to see you guys touching and enjoying each other on the dance floor at the moment. Not so many people are able to do that.
Thank you.
That's, I almost have tears in my eyes because Ashley touched me. So beautiful.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Vito. We'd like to thank you all again for giving us this possibility.
Yes, thank you so much.
This was absolutely fantastic that we could do that. And yeah, thank you so much for doing that.
And we were thinking, like, as a final words, that actually I feel knowledge is our power, right? So
absolutely,
learning and going to these details and digging even more, we all improve our qualities personal, but we also improve the quality of the industry. So I feel it's great that we have this opportunity to learn from each other like that.
We are very honored. We're very honored to have you guys
for us.
Thank you.
I hope everybody enjoyed it like we did. Dana and I watched it, all of it. It was fantastic and amazing on a rainy day in England. A bit of sunny now, crappy day. Anyway, it doesn't
right
matter.
Right of the day.
It doesn't matter.
Thank you.
Thank you guys, thank you. And please everybody remember to join us next week for another amazing Zoomina lecture. Thank you so much. Bye-bye Nicole, thank you all. Bye Sasha, bye Clement.
Thank you.
Bye, thank you.
Thank you so much.